G'day guys, the Grass Slasher here, and welcome to my channel. Well, so last time I reposted this video that I've done last year, and as you can see, there's so much rubbish in the yard. I had to clear it first before I could do any mowing and whippersnipping. But just a bit of a backstory here why there's so much trash in the yard. Well, she've known a person, or this person, for 15 years, that when they became homeless, she allowed them to stay in her place. But unfortunately, this friends of hers abused the place and left all the rubbish. But if you want the full story, please check the links in the description. And you can read the full story in the description on the links. All right, so back to present. When I reposted this video and decided I would help her again, everyone had different reaction. Some are curious why there's so much trash, and some are inferring that I shouldn't do the third time, or I shouldn't help her anymore. Well, she contacted me last week and informed me that they had to leave the place due to DV, or domestic violence. They were living in a DV shelter somewhere, and for safety purposes, I won't mention that place. She and her daughters haven't been back to the place. She asked me to give her a price on how much to mow her yard. She's about to hand back the keys to the landlord. Well, I replied and told her that I'm fully booked in the next 3 weeks. So unfortunately, I won't be able to do it straight away. But I told her that if the landlord is willing to wait, I'm still happy to help her once I have availability. She was happy about it. She agreed to it. Because initially she was going back to the place to pick up some of their things, as they had to leave everything in the property. But I received a message from her the following day, or probably after 2 days. She said that the landlord is happy to take care of the lawns and they'll tidy it up for her, because unfortunately it's not safe anymore for her and her kids to go back to the house, so they have to leave everything behind. I've also got the landlord's number, and we'll try and contact them and see whether they'll let me work on the yard, or whether I'm allowed to, or if it's safe to go onto that property. But we'll find out in the next couple of days. But yes, that's the lady's story and her situation. It's very unfortunate. However, we'll try and see whether I could get this yard done and film it as well. Well, every time I see an overgrown yard and I see the yard in a terrible condition, I always assume that there's a good reason behind it.
Next week,
I don't pry, as I know that sometimes it's personal and maybe too embarrassing to tell the story. Some will openly tell their story and just needed to vent, to which I'm also happy to listen. And I can understand everyone's concern in the comments section, and everyone is entitled to their opinion. I hope this lady and her daughters can find a better place, and hope things will turn out well for them. Well, thanks everyone for listening, and please enjoy the video.
Oh, Peace.